In this edition of Impact, we meet two recipients of donated organs.
One organ donor can save up to 8 lives as an organ donor and help up to 50 people as a tissue donor.
But first, we go into the lives of families caring for relatives with rare diseases.
I could do mostly anything that a regular person could do. It's just the extra care.
Welcome to Impact. I'm Shi Chao Ma. In this episode, we explore the lives of people who are fighting for a chance at a normal life. In our first segment, we see some challenges faced by two patients living with rare diseases. Diagnosed at a young age, they've learned how to embrace the uncertainty of their futures.
Growing up, until I was maybe teenage years, I had a really good childhood. I really didn't feel like I had a disability. I just thought I was normal. I had toys, like everybody did. I went to school, like everybody went to school. The only difference was that I couldn't walk.
The disease is hard to deal with, but if you really try, it's like nothing. I could do mostly anything that a regular person could do. It's just the extra care, like with all my pills and my treatments. But the treatments are only like in the night when I go to sleep and the morning when I wake up. Javier Arriola. I'm 10 years old. When I was coming to the children's hospital, I was around a year and a half. They found out that I had cystic fibrosis and that I needed special care. These are my treatments. I have to start with my vest. It helps open my lungs so then I could breathe better, so then mucus can't get inside my lungs. First, I have to deal with it. I have a G-tube and it helps me gain more weight throughout the night because I have medicine throughout the night. Before, when I didn't have this, I weighed like around 30 pounds, and now I weigh 65 pounds. Now, during the night, I have to do these feedings. I do 3 cans. I usually do 3 cans a night, but right now I'm just doing one. During the day, it's one.
A las 8 o 9 de la noche, ahí empieza el trabajo como mamá. Ahí empiezo los tratamientos de Javier, empiezo a llenarle su bolsita de leche, empiezo a conectarlo, sus medicinas por el tubo, y yo termino alrededor de 11 y media, 12 de la noche.
There's this little tunnel thing, and then you open my tube, click it in, lock it. Now, turn it on.
En la madrugada, como toma leche, también tengo que darle pastillas. Me levanto a las 3 de la mañana a darle sus pastillas. Y para amanecer, tengo que levantarme antes de las 6 de la mañana a ponerle otra vez sus tratamientos.
I think what's really hard with a rare disease is there isn't a community out there. In order to get one, you have to start it. Now you're already overwhelmed with having this child with this rare disease. Being a caretaker is extremely draining. You know, you lose your life.
All my family that I have a sister and a dad and a mom. It's a big deal for them.
Pero conforme fue pasando el tiempo, vimos que era una enfermedad tremenda. A él le afectan sus pulmones y agarra neumonías muy, muy seguido. Y el saber que tu niño puede estar bien ahorita y que mañana se te puede morir, eso para una familia es terrible.
In the United States alone, there's 25 million Americans with rare diseases, most of them children. And that's just the United States. I mean, I have 550 rare pediatric diseases on my database. It's constantly growing. It's rare diseases aren't so rare anymore.
Get a Spider-Man?
Yep, but with a different mask.
I got it. ¿Sí? En México solamente me decían que era falta de calcio, que era debilidad que tenía, pero nunca me dijeron que esa enfermedad tenía.
In SMA, in the spinal cord, there is a particular cell called the anterior horn cell, which is responsible for the nerve, which makes our muscles move. And in SMA, there is a deterioration of that cell. So there is a miscommunication or a lack of communication between the brain and our muscles.
The more and more my back was shaped again, it was turning into my lungs. And that, in the end, would have caused my life to be shorter.
That's right, you have no resistance onto those bones. They can get weaker. You get curved back or scoliosis. Your bones can get thin because of disuse.
Everything that is a muscle in my body is in a with time decrease. My eyesight, my breathing, my heart. It's just something I know I have to deal with.
Yeah. That's Titanic?
Yeah.
He comido enfrente de ella. A mí se me hace triste estar yo comiendo y que ella me esté viendo.
But when it just happens from one minute to the next, and when it's something so big as the pleasures of eating, that's hard. I didn't want to be here anymore. I didn't want to spend my whole life on the bed in the room. I didn't want it. But I have a really good family.
Well, first I'm going to be a scientist to find a cure. Then after that, I'm going to quit being a scientist and be a doctor to help the kids. But maybe it's going to be a little too late because I don't think they will need helping because there will be a cure for it already. I missed.
I think this is like her third baby.
No way.
Mm-hmm. Her second.
I think everybody would want a cure, especially if you're the one living with it. I don't know how much more time I have, and I know I'm such a big part of their life, but when I'm not there anymore, I want my mom to be with me.